guys, welcome back to Mighty Good Gaming. I'm Dustin, your host, doing a game review for Assassin's Creed Origins. Finished the storyline today. Right about 50-something hours, 51, 52, somewhere around there. And I have to say, I loved it. It was great. Love the way they have moved the series to more of an action RPG along the lines of Horizon Zero Dawn, The Witcher 3. Now we have Assassin's Creed in the same vein of games. Can't say enough about how much I really, really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed Bike, the main character. He had a very compelling story. He was a likable character. And also Aya, his wife, she was also playable at certain points. And she, too, was very enjoyable, very likable. Just very, very well-rounded game. I finished at level 35. I know the max level at 40. And a lot of the quests, the side quests, like the Trials of the Gods and stuff like that, you have to be level 40 to, I guess you don't have to, but you're going to have a very hard time. I tried the Trial of Anubis at level 35, and I died pretty quickly. Some of the enemies he spawns are way above my level, so there's plenty of stuff to do after you finish the campaign of the game. Like I said, I finished finished the storyline 50-something hours, and sorry, I have a game going in the background. 50-something hours to finish the main storyline and stuff, and I think I may have covered a little more than half of the map. I didn't do all the side quests, like I said. I'm going to go back and do that stuff, but I thought it was, I was going to finish up the storyline, and that way I can do a review before the new year, let you guys know how I liked it and stuff. But I have to say, it's probably one of the best games that I have played this year. I would highly recommend Assassin's Creed Origins, especially if you are looking for a really good open-world action-adventure RPG. Stealth elements on this game, I know a lot of people don't like the stealth that is so heavy in the Assassin's Creed games. This is completely different. If you want to go in sword-swinging, whatever you can. If you want to be all sneaky, you can do that too. It leaves it open to complete the mission how you want. And I really, really like that about it. They kind of did the same thing with Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain. Metal Gear was also large stealth, largely based around stealth. And now that franchise is kind of how you want to complete the mission. That open world style of game is getting extremely popular. And it is very, very well done. Assassin's Creed got over 50 E3 awards and nominations. I can definitely see why. The fact that this game was not nominated for Game of the Year is a real shame. I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed it as much as I did Horizon Zero Dawn or any of the other games that came out this year. I can't say enough good things about it. Graphics are gorgeous. The environments, just Egypt apparently has a lot of variety, because you have everything from like the deserts to mountains to swampy marshes to, you know, even small sections of the open sea are available to you. You can explore the Sphinx, pyramids. Jumping off the top of a pyramid and sliding down, that was just, you know, that was one of the best gaming moments of this year. And like I said, I would highly recommend it. Definitely give it 2 thumbs up. And like I said, I'd recommend it. I played this on Xbox One. And I know it is enhanced beautifully on the Xbox One X. I watched the video that Digital Foundry put out comparing the Xbox One X version to the PS4 Pro version, and there is a difference. The game is just, like I said, it's a beautiful, beautiful game. I played it on the standard Xbox One, and I thought it was beautiful. So, I mean, if you got the 4K TV and you want a system to play it on, I would recommend playing it in on PS4 Pro or Xbox One X, either one. Like I said, I played it on the standard, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. I thought it was a gorgeous game, and just to see the touch-ups that they have done with the Xbox One X version as opposed to the standard version. Small details, but it just adds that much more to it, and I would definitely recommend it. So anyway, guys, like I said, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would probably give this game probably a 9.25. It's probably one of the best games that came out this year. In my opinion, I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I would highly recommend it to anyone. So anyway, guys, that does it for the review. Hope you've enjoyed it. Check out my other reviews. We'll be launching a review for Tales from the Borderlands as well. Completed that one yesterday, and Assassin's Creed Origins today. So we're going to, and also going to get into what I'm playing next. So guys, be good, stay classy, and I'll catch you later.